Have you ever seen streetlights magically turn on at sunset? Hey guys, in today's video, I will explain what is an LDR and how it works. Stick around because by the end of this video, you'll understand what an LDR is and how it's transforming electronic devices. An LDR, or light-dependent resistor, is a resistor whose resistance changes based on the amount of light it is exposed to. Typically, these resistors have high resistance in the dark and low resistance in the bright light. This unique property makes them incredibly useful for sensing light levels in various applications. The technical term for this change in resistance is photoconductivity, a game changer in circuits responding to light conditions. Now let's break down how an LDR works. An LDR is made from a high-resistance semiconductor material that absorbs photons. When light hits the LDR, photons energize the semiconductor's electrons, allowing them to jump across energy gaps and conduct electricity. What happens when there is no light? Fewer electrons make the jump, and the resistance stays high. What happens when there is a bright light? More electrons can move, decreasing the resistance. This simple yet effective mechanism allows LDRs to act like automatic switches based on light. You might be wondering, where is an LDR used? From automatic streetlights that turn on at dusk, to security systems that detect if a room is occupied based on light. LDRs are crucial in consumer electronics, such as cameras that adjust the shutter speed based on ambient light. Let's put theory into practice by setting up a simple circuit to test an LDR on a breadboard. In this circuit, the power source is a 9-volt battery. I will use a red LED, which has a forward voltage of 2 volts and current of 20 milliamps. Use Ohm's law to calculate the resistance. Subtract 2 volts from 9 volts to give us 7 volts. Divide 7 volts by 0.02 amps to get 350 ohms. I'm going to use a larger resistance, or 470 ohms. The LDR is rated at around 2.7 kilo ohms. Now it's time to set up this circuit. Start by inserting the red jumper wire into the positive side of the breadboard. Insert the black jumper wire into the negative side of the breadboard. Connect the red jumper cable to the red jumper wire. Connect the black jumper cable to the black jumper wire. This is a 470 ohms resistor. This resistor will help control the current flowing through the LED to prevent it from burning out. Bend the wire ends of the resistor. Insert the left side of the resistor into the same column as the red jumper wire. This is a red LED with a forward voltage of 2 volts. The anode, or positive side, has the longer leg. Make sure the anode is on the left side. Insert the red LED into the same row as the resistor. This is the LDR, a light-dependent resistor. Insert the LDR into the same column as the red LED. Make sure the wire on the right side is in the same column as the negative terminal. Connect the red jumper wire to the positive terminal of the 9-volt battery. Connect the black jumper wire to the negative terminal of the 9-volt battery. Since we have the circuit properly connected, the LED lights up. To test the LDR, I will shade it with my hand. Observe how the brightness of the LED changes. The LED is very dim when I cover the LDR. If you enjoyed this explanation of LDR, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you won't miss out on my upcoming videos. Got any ideas for what you would do with an LDR? Drop a comment below. I love to hear your inventive thoughts. Thanks for watching and see you next time.